Sonia Delaunay. Born the 18th of November, 1885 in Russia. At a young age, she moved to St. Petersburg to care for Henry Turk, a successful attorney who was her mother's brother. His wife, Anna Turk, took such a liking to Sonia that she wanted to adopt her, but Sonia's mother wouldn't allow it. In 1890, she was finally adopted by the Turks and took on the surname, becoming Sonia Turk. And with the Turks is where Sonia found her love for art. She grew up privileged. They spent their summers in Finland and widely traveled Europe, where she explored art museums and galleries. At 16, she attended a secondary school, where her talent was noted by her teacher. She went on to study at the Academy of Fine Arts in Germany until 1905, when she made her way to Paris. When arriving in Paris, she spent most of her time viewing art galleries and growing her skills. Her work during this time was greatly influenced by post-impressionist art figures, such as Van Gogh, Henri Rousseau, Matisse, and Derain. In 1908, she and art gallery owner Wilhelm Ude conveniently married, allowing her access to his gallery, dealings, and connections in the art world, and him a way to mask his homosexuality. Sonia would regularly see Robert Delaunay in art galleries, and they quickly fell in love. As Sonia and her first husband got a divorce, she married Robert in April of that year. They then had a son, who they named Charles. In 1911, art critics began to notice her step back from naturalism and a step forward into cubism. And in 1912 to 1913, Sonia curated her first large-scale painting in this style, called Balbuliere, known for its use of both color and movement. A friend of Sonia's was a poet and coined the word orphism to describe the style of Sonia's version of cubism. The Delaunays traveled to Spain in 1914 during the outbreak of the First World War. While in Portugal, Sonia painted Market in Minho in 1916, which she later said was inspired by the beauty of the country. 1917 brought an end to the financial support from her family following the Russian Revolution. In need of a new source of income, she met Sergei Diaghilev in Madrid. Sonia designed the costumes for his production of Cleopatra, while her husband did the stage design. They did the same with a production of Aida in Barcelona. Sonia went on to decorate a nightclub and founded Casa Sonia, where she showcased and sold her designs for interior decoration and fashion. Sonia returned to Paris twice in 1920 looking for work. In August of that year, she wrote Paul Poiret a letter regarding business opportunities accompanied by some of her designs, but he declined. In 1921, the Delaunays made their way back to Paris, where their financial issues were fixed after they sold a painting for a hefty price. Sonia designed and made clothing for many private clients and friends until 1923, when she created 50 fabric designs using geometric shapes and bold colors. Soon after, she designed the set and costumes for a production of The Gas-Operated Heart by author Tristan Tzara. In 1924, she opened her own fashion studio with Jacques Hem, where they made clothing for many well-known figures. In the later 1920s, Sonia designed costumes for two films, Le Vertige and La Petite Perigotte. She also designed the furniture for the set of Because I Love You in 1929. During this time, Sonia also created haute couture textile designs for Robert Perrier. Then the Great Depression struck, forcing Sonia to close down her business and once again indulge herself in painting, while still designing for Jacques Hem, Metz & Co., and Robert Perrier. By the end of 1934, Sonia had decorated two pavilions. Her husband Robert Delaunay passed due to cancer in October of 1941. After the Second World War, Sonia was a board member of the Salon des Réalités Nouvelles. She held the position for several years. In 1964, Sonia and her son Charles donated 114 of her and her husband's art to the National Museum of Modern Art in France. She decorated sports cars, became one of the only painters to have art shown in the Louvre, and so much more. In 1976, she partnered with a company called Art Curio, where she designed textiles, tableware, and jewelry, all inspired by her work from the 20s. Sonia passed away the 5th of December, 1979. Sonia Delaunay's work has played an evident role in the development of the art world through fashion, painting, architecture, textile design, and so much more. Here is a piece that I created inspired by Sonia Delaunay's work. Thank you all for watching, and I hope everyone enjoyed exploring the life and work of Sonia Delaunay.